lives at Lurkot, Minneapolis's cafe and bar. Lurkot was just named in Yelp's 2019 top 100 most romantic restaurants across the United States, and they still have reservations available for Valentine's Day. Chef Jordan Swiler is here along with GM Michelle Jensen. Great to have you both here.
Thank you for having
Thank
us.
Thank you for coming in. We've been staring at this food for like 10 minutes, and it looks amazing. But first, let's start with your Valentine's Day menu. You guys have something special going on this weekend, don't you?
Yes. So on Thursday, Valentine's, we're doing a $90 per person prefix menu. We're starting our service at 5 o'clock. We'll serve till 11. We've got live music starting right up at 5:30 and then running until 11 o'clock. And then of course, Friday and Saturday, we have live music as well.
And for those people, not presently included, by the way, who have not made plans for Valentine's Day yet, okay, I haven't. You have reservations available?
Yes, we do. We've got reservations starting at 5:30. And again, we're serving all the way until 11. So if you want to do something earlier on in the evening and then catch a later dinner, 9 o'clock, we've got reservations open right now.
Perfect. So. Jordan, tell me some of the, first of all, what do you have out here? The food looks amazing.
Thank you. Yeah, this is our steak tartare that'll be on Valentine's Day. We have our miso sea bass that a lot of people are pretty familiar with.
Yeah, that looks good.
Mixed green down in the front there, smoked goat cheese. The pork chop, we have a little bit of blue cheese butter and a couple of desserts as well.
That looks awesome. Bobby is so jealous. It's too bad he isn't here because he loves steak tartare. And you're going to make us a tenderloin dish, correct?
Yeah, I'm going to make the mushrooms that are basically on top of this right here.
So, very cool.
Start the pan pretty hot. We have some really nice oyster mushrooms here.
Oyster mushrooms.
Yeah, and you don't want to add too many to the pan so you can get a little bit of caramelization on there.
Okay.
If you add too many, it'll just kind of steam. So
you don't want that, right?
You don't want that. Nope.
While we're cooking that, tell us a little bit about the motif and how the place looks for Valentine's weekend.
Well, not just on Valentine's, just in general, the space is really romantic on its own. You know, we've been there for over 14 years now. The space is a historical space, and it has a gorgeous view of Loring Park, and there's nothing like it in the city. So low dim lighting and candles everywhere.
What were some of the criteria as far as getting on Yelp's top 100 most romantic places?
It's, you know, it is a date night spot.
Yeah.
We have a lot of couples that come in, but we also have a lot of families that come and have a quiet dinner together, an intimate dinner.
Okay.
And, you know, we do a lot of weddings, do a lot of rehearsal dinners. So it's just a place that just exudes love.
Very
I think
cool.
that's why we won, and we're really
well,
happy.
Quite
it's
a good honor. Congratulations.
Yeah, thank you.
So how long are we keeping those on?
So we'll get this going until they're a little bit of caramelization on them.
Yep.
After that, we're going to add some red onions.
Mm-hmm.
And you just kind of let that go for a little bit. A little bit.
I should have asked this. That's olive oil, correct?
Yeah.
We're using olive oil?
Yep.
Okay.
Yeah, and we cooked the beef a little bit earlier. I know you prefer grilling.
We were talking about that in the break about frying pan versus grill.
Right.
You put it on the, you do the broiler
We have
the
a
restaurant.
Broiler at the restaurant. We're lucky to have all the nice equipment here. But
of course.
You can kind of do it however you want to do it. And I know you like the grill. I mean, if at home, if it's too cold. Absolutely.
I like any steak, I'm going to be honest
right.
with you. Any grill, broiler, I don't care. It's all good.
Nice. So, and I have a couple of these already done, but we're going to add just a little bit of garlic.
There you go.
A little bit of
fresh
thyme.
I like that little, by the way. That's a pretty
like spoon.
That's a pretty liberal.
There's no such thing as
small
too much
amount of garlic.
Now.
And
even
then just a little
Valentine's
bit of butter.
Day.
And that'll just kind of cool the pan down. I'm going to kill the heat here.
Okay. And we have a little bit less than a minute left. So tell me about the sauce that you made. Is that?
So I have a red wine syrup
that
we made at the restaurant.
Mm-hmm.
And basically, we'll throw that together. I have the beef here waiting
Through
for
the
you.
Magic of television.
Yeah, you know, I figured you always eating cold stuff. I'll give you some hot stuff.
Well, we're not picky. That
so,
looks
yeah.
wonderful.
We'll
and
plate
you place
this
that
up
right
in the middle.
There.
Yep.
Look at that. And you like that. To serve these medium? What's your favorite?
I prefer medium rare, but
medium
we can
rare,
do
yeah.
wherever you want to go with
my
that.
I used to eat medium rare, and then I went to medium, and my father shunned me ever since.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you so much. That's delicious.
Absolutely.
We're going to dig into that in a second. Cafe and Bar Lurkot are located at 1624 Harmon Place in Minneapolis. We have a link to this recipe on care11.com. Thanks so much for coming in.
Thank you.